Hey guys! I hope you guys can hear me. My microphone has been messing up lately and I don't know how to fix it. So today guys, we're going to be following CallMeCam8's IceWing tutorial. Since she doesn't have any like RainWing tutorials or anything else. So I hope you guys have a great time watching this because I'm probably going to suffer through the whole thing. Oh no, I suck at drawing IceWings. Actually no, I'm actually quite good at drawing IceWings. Any two-winged Pyrian dragon, I'm pretty good at. So first of all, we're going to change a couple things. So we're going to get canvas size, and we're making the width. Ooh, that's really big. You know what? We're going to do a square canvas. That's something I never draw on. There we go! So because mainly she starts her videos off with an insane thing that I can't do, we're gonna try and make this as sane as we can because she's probably gonna take an hour to make this just alone. I don't want this video to be in over an hour, so we're gonna try and do a 20-minute deadline, so this is also gonna be quite rushed. So how about we just watch it through? So this is basically picking her pose and whatnot. There.
Yeah. Yeah, if you've seen any of my videos, you'll know that I always start off the drawings that I make with these blobby shapes. These help me get the proportions as close to where I want as possible. You can do this step or the stick.
Okay, so basically, we gotta start off with the blobby shapes. Her words, not mine. Blobby shapes. I love that, actually. We start off with blobby shapes. So let's start off with some blobby shapes, and first of all, we're gonna choose a pose, and I already know what pose I want my dragon to be in, luckily. So we're gonna draw blobby shape here. Yay. Yeah, okay. Oh my god, that looks so bad.
Okay, I give up, he's gone.
What?
That's gone.
Are you kidding me? What do you mean?
Not looking for him. How long did it take me to open that door, turn around, put my shoes on, and walk out there?
Like 3 minutes?
Not even. I just not opened even. The door.
Guys, I'm back. Okay, so we're gonna start off with blobby shapes, like I said before. We're gonna make these lines a little bit better. This one's gonna be Finder staring at the moon, so she's gonna have a little bit of a curved face. Very curved, actually. Oh god. You know what? That's fine. We gotta fill this in anyway. So, basically, in this part of the video, CallMeCam8 explains that this is so you can basically see the proportions of the dragon's body. Makes enough sense when you think of it. I usually know what a dragon's shape already is by proportion, so I don't usually do this step, but if you really feel the need to, it's completely okay. So she's also using different colors. If you look in the video, she's using different colors to mark where everything is. So I think I'm gonna do that too. We're gonna do the wing limb like this.
No.
Okay. So now that we've done that, all right, I'm recording. So I think we've got basically the dragon design now. I might do a back leg over here. We don't know if I'll do that yet. We'll see. I think the next part we should do is the next step. So.
The version that I see a lot of other artists use, it's whatever you find easier.
Next is step two, my outline or second sketch. Sometimes I feel really confident I can skip this step in my drawings, but I did it here to make things easier on myself and to show you all. This is the stage where you give your shape some of its outlines and start to figure out the placement of the eyes and the facial features, as well as getting a better idea of how the line art will look and how the basic features and build of the dragon will tie together. This is also the stage where you start to see the features that will define your dragon as the type you're trying to draw, and in this case, ice wings. Some important features to remember are that IceWings are very sleek feature dragons, with their smooth bodies and very sharp points. You have to keep in mind their most dominant features, like their narrow, smooth heads, sharp horns, strong shoulders, long tails, and of course, the spikes on their neck and tail. Next is stage 3.
Alright, before we go on to stage 3, we gotta do stage 2, so we're gonna start doing that.
Can I play stuff or no? Can you go do that in your room?
No.
Why?
I need the table to do the drawing.
So I guess I go to my room then.
Sorry. I mean, I can record tomorrow.
Oh, that's alright. I'll go tomorrow.
Alright. But I think it's looking fine. I think it's looking fine. Still coming out just fine. So, now this is the third step.
Force the spikes on your neck and tail. Next is stage 3, the basic line art. In this stage, I'm mostly just tracing over the shape with some clearer, neater lines. I also added the spikes along the spine, on the neck, and at the end of the tail. As well as that, in this stage, I start adding just slightly more detail than what I already had. This just makes everything look a little neater. In this stage, I've already been paying more attention to the thickness of the lines that I'm using because this will be a part of the finished product. The next stage is stage...
Okay. So basically, now we've got to add some detail to our dragon. That sounds easy, doesn't it? Okay, I think that's basically step 4 complete, or step 3 complete. Let's move on to step 4.
4, scale details. This is the stage where I add all the details and the markings on the body. IceWings have layered scales like diamonds on their forehead, and the lowest one extends down their snout to between their nostrils. When it comes to the neck, IceWings have 4 rows of triangle scales going down the neck that are tight and fit together nicely at the base of their neck, and are more loose and scattered near the head. Their tail is different, as it only has 2 rows of scales, and unlike other tribes, doesn't have a clear line from where their main body meets the underbelly. When it comes to their arms, IceWings have sharp triangle scales on their lower arms, and while their shoulders and thighs barely have any markings. Anyways, hope that was helpful. Have fun drawing y'all's SOCs.
Alright. Can you not? Oh my god. You have it wrapped around your neck. Really, dude? How did you do that? Sorry, my dog is trying to throttle himself with my mouse. Ugh. This is so fun. Okay, so basically now we're going into scale detailing. So, yeah. I don't know how I'm going to do that last part, because you kind of just painted that all with one color. Did you see that? Look how she did that. That's impossible.
Let's help us have fun drawing houses of seas.
Wow. That doesn't make any sense. How do I do that? How? Does it make any sense? Oh my god. Oh, now we're unplugged again. Okay, thank you. Alright, let's do that, shall we? Hey guys, just before I color her in, I just found out this little trick. Hold on. Work. Look at it, just glitches out so badly for like 5 seconds. Oh no. Alright, final product. I can't carry on.
Try.